Am I good?
How did you hear about tonight?
Hear about?
GoGay.com. That's your site over there. TJ told you where all the gays were gathering. I said, look for a rainbow flag and sparkles and all of that. Happy Pride, everybody. You know, this is all Pride Month, so we're just going to celebrate. Let me say it again. Happy Pride, everybody. It is a wonderful time. It is a great time to be gay in America. I love it. I think really to be Pride is 365 days a year. Could you please give our wonderful Kimberly Bush, the wonderful lady in charge of Real Affirmation, a round of applause. Our amazing DJ, he's great. We love him. He's very shy. You know, he's slowly coming out of his shell. Soon he'll be one of us. He's our little brother. No, he's actually one of our straight allies, and we love him too. We need the straight. We need the breeders so we can have more children. It's so important. We do love you. But he loves the gays, and he's always here to support us, and we thank you so much. Bless you. Give him a round of applause. Speaking of breeders, do we have any married couples in the building? You're unmarried? How long have you been together?
Almost 25 years.
Legally five. Okay, that's wonderful. How about you, my beloved?
9 years.
9 years of lesbian time, that's 18. How about you?
20 years.
20 years, that's wonderful. Anybody else?
Married four, together 11.
That's wonderful. It can work. Anybody else? How about you, my dear?
7 married, 12 together.
Oh, that's wonderful. These gays are really doing it. So all the gays outside. So it's hope for all the single gays. You can really find somebody. You can get married. It's hope for all of us. It is hope. I'm a widow, but I love it. It's a wonderful thing. I'm the host. If you've never seen me, I'm the host of the Rayceen Show, which is here. First Wednesdays of every month. It's free. It's an LGBT live talk show. If you haven't heard about it, now you have. It is live music, we have burlesque, we have a happy hour, and the greatest word in the English language, free. Follow me, Rayceen, on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, all of those sort of things. If you put it in wrong, you get a porn star. If you put it in right, you get me. So, you know, that's a wonderful thing. We have a great time always. It's a wonderful experience. I'm so glad the HRC is a place that affirms us every day of the week. And to all of our wonderful sponsors, AHF, they're amazing. All of our other sponsors over here. Come on here, would you like to say something? You're one of our proud sponsors. You just want to wave in the corner and be there. Okay, all right. Just want another one of our sponsors over here. A round of applause, Tito, homemade vodka. Yes, honey, it tastes like Miss Sally's gin and all of that, and it's a wonderful experience. Get drunk on it. Of course, they always have me doing everything. So, you know, I've got to plug everything. You know, this year has been an amazing year. I've lived to see a lot of things, and I'm so happy I have lived to see the first Capital Pride, first Black Pride, first Trans Pride, first Latinx Pride, first Youth Pride. Now we had the first ever Silver Pride. And for all of those who are over 50 and over, we are celebrating the experience of the AARP members of America. Courtesy brought to you by Shady Pines. My co-hosts have been Rose, Sophia, Dorothy, and Blanche. And it's been a wonderful experience. And also next week, Terrific Inc. has partnered up with the Office on Aging. And we will be having Pride Has No Age. It's a wonderful, amazing event. It is full of drama, full of fun, full of everything. So if you go to www.terrificinc.org or pick up a lovely gift bag on your way out, and inside that gift bag, it has all of this information. So it's a wonderful event. So we're celebrating our seniors, because sometimes they forget us at Pride, and sometimes we have to push those young people down and remind them. We have to remind them, bitch, if it wasn't for us, it would be no you. Also, and that's true, we have to remind young people, you know, that they sometimes feel like they can push us aside, but they can't. you young bitches suffer. You know, I remind him, honey, I took a brick so you could twirl. So, you know, I have to remind him, girl.
You know, girl.
I have to remind him every day that they twirling on television. It makes me so proud. Speaking of television, have y'all watched the new series, Pose?
Yeah.
Oh my God, if you, how many people have not heard, have heard about it or have not seen it? Have you not seen it, raise your hands. It's on FX. It is Pose. Please watch it. It's a wonderful show. It's based around the ballroom community, like Paris is Burning in the 80s, but it's more than just ballroom. It is telling our stories in such an authentic, an amazing way. And most of my friends, 95% of my friends are on that show. But it's the first ever largest trans cast ever. So that's the first time ever. So it's important that we watch it so the numbers can continue to go up so they can renew it for season two. So please watch that because it's a wonderful. And also, the Outright Festival. How many people have been to the Outright Festival, which is a celebration of the LGBT authors and writers? If how many have never been? We got a lot of first timers. Bam! So now you know about it. It's August 4th from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. It is at 2014 Street Northwest. It is open to the public and it's free. It's a wonderful experience. Come out, support it. You can meet authors, they have workshops. It's going to be a great all-day experience. Come out, have a great time. It's going to be so amazing. And it's going to be simply fabulous. Also, I also talk about, I'm a contributor to several magazines. Of course, I'm queen of shameless plug. I gotta plug everything. So please pick up a copy of this wonderful, wonderful magazine. It's called Love and Lust in the Time of Pride. So it talks about the experiences that we have during Pride. That sometimes we get caught up, and sometimes the children get caught up and get robbed during Pride. So be safe. You know, if you have a date or a one-nighter, please remember to be safe. So it's a wonderful experience. Also, I'm a contributor for Swerve magazine. And inside, it talks about the going away of the gay neighborhoods. And I wrote this article because I noticed how gentrification has hit the gays. All across the country, from the Castros to Christopher Street to DuPont Circle, our neighborhoods are slowly going away. And we have to fight for everything. So it's important to keep our neighborhoods ours. So the next little young LGBTQI, can you believe how many letters we got, Anne? Before I die, we're going to have XYZ, MONOP, all on that. But, you know, to let them know that it's okay, you can be affirmed in safe spaces. So that's why it's important that we keep our spaces. Do we have any dancers in the building? Anybody have a dancer? I'm sorry. Anybody? Oh, you hit your wife. Boom. Come on up here, baby. She done put you out on Front Street. Come on up here, sweetheart. Come in. Come on. We're going to have a good time. I'm going to hold your hand the whole time. I won't let you go. Yes, honey. She's going to cheer you on. Cheer you. That's how it met. You in the boom boom room. Yes, give me one more. I need one more. Come on. Yeah. Oh, she put you on Front Street. Bam. Come on up here, sweetheart. What's your name?
Lauren.
And how? Oh, Lauren, where you from? Texas, where they're growing big and you carry a gun on a regular basis. Texas, where are you from?
Asheville, North Carolina.
And what's your name?
Maya.
Oh, Asheville, North Carolina. They have gays here in Asheville, North Carolina. I think it's wonderful. So they have two gays. And they were all at the Piggly Wiggly.
Don't you have Piggly Wigglies down here? What y'all have? Wawa's or Waffle House?
I know you do. Yeah. Stay away from the Waffle House. Okay, come on over here. We're going to give you a little space. You're going to be one, and you're going to be two. All right? That's all right. You're going to dance and have a good time, honey. We're going to have a good time, and we have gifts for you if you win. So you're going to be contestant number one. You're going to be contestant number two. Contestant number one, DJ, if you please. Yes. Oh, let's see what you got. Let's see what you got, honey. Oh, look at her. Everybody is loving everything. She is loving it. She is, that's how you got it. Show us how you got it. Show us how you keep her. Oh, how did you get her? Oh, woo. I love it. Give her a round of applause, honey. That's all right. You got plenty of rhythm. But we'll talk about how you got her later, honey. The book is coming out. Contestant number two, hit it. gift. We're giving you both a gift. An amazing gift bag for both of you. Both of you are winners. Give them another round of applause. That's how we do it, honey. Everybody's a winner. Yes, honey, go over there. Your wife is going, she's going to show your grandkids this. Say, look at Nana. This is Nana when she was young. Oh, my God. So, okay, cool. So I can talk about a lot of things. So, which is wonderful. I can always talk, I can always stretch, and I can always have a good time. It is so important that we, let me just say that we are, even though it is, how many people are district residents? You're a district resident? Okay, and you voted? Did you vote this week? Good. Please vote. Voting is important. They love the gay vote. And our vote matters. It's so important. It's good. Good God. Every time you turn on the news, there's so much going on. It's so frustrating sometimes. Isn't it overwhelming a lot? When you turn on the television, it's very overwhelming. Sometimes I just want to shoot that damn television. You know I do. But everybody, this is how we always do it in Real Affirmations. Everybody stand up. Stand on up. Stand on up, honey. We got to affirm ourselves always. Put your purses and your bags and your watches and your phones down and your drinks. Yes, put it down. Put it down! Now I want everybody to take a minute to just breathe in. Breathe in. Now I want you to close your eyes. And I just want you to, it's been a rough week. All the stuff that you took through the week. All the stuff, the times you wanted to kick your boss's ass, the children getting on your nerves, even your spouse might have got on your nerves. The next door neighbor was doing shows, they didn't turn the TV off and you can hear it upstairs. But all the times that you've just been frustrated, every time you turn on the news and you watch all the stuff at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, and all the stuff going on there, and all the stuff that's happening to these beautiful people who come over to this country and they just want to be free. And they're being separated from their children and from their families. Now let it go. Breathe out and just let it go. And wrap your arms around yourself and love yourself because you are the greatest gift. Know that we as LGBTQI people have gone through so much in this country and we have the right at the table and we deserve to be there. Now open your eyes and turn to your neighbor and give them a hug and say hello. Now you can settle down.